Mr. Speaker, sir. At the outset, I'm so thankful to the Honourable Member, Pak Lakmen Rumbui, for bringing in this special motion, and also the Honourable Members, Pak Meryl Bond Siem, Pak Aden Basau Moit. Ba Renikton, Ba Balajit Sinrem, Dr. Mukul Sangma, and also Ba Brightstar Will, Mabjang local MLA from Maulai, for participating in this very important subject, the motion, the special motion, which is talking about the unemployment scenario that prevails in the state of Meghalaya. Sir, I would like to take this opportunity to apprise this house on the unemployment scenario in the state and the various initiatives taken by the government for curbing the unemployment problem. Basically, unemployment is a global problem, and the International Labour Organization has projected that it will increase in 2024. In 2023, the global unemployment rate was 5.1%, which is a minimal improvement from that of 2022, which was 5.3%. However, the International Labour Organization, World Employment and Social Outlook Trends 2024 report predicts that the rate will increase to 5.2% in 2024. The report also states that an additional 2 million people are expected to be looking for work in the next year. Unemployment rate in India is measured by multiple survey sources, National Sample Survey Organizations, Periodic Labor Force Survey, and Center for Monitoring Indian Economy's Unemployment Survey are the two prominent surveys done in India. Since methodology used by both surveys are significantly different, hence can lead to varying results. In the case of Meghalaya, the latest official figures provided by the Periodic Labour Force Survey, unemployment rate is at 6%. However, it is crucial to note that this figure is 1 year old and does not accurately represent the current employment dynamics of financial year 2024. Hence, to understand the current situation of employment in the state, we can refer to the Center for Monitoring of Indian Economy database, which provides latest figures for unemployment till January 2024 and updates them monthly. The latest CMIE data for 2024 indicates that unemployment rate of Meghalaya stands at 2.98%, which is below the national average of 6.78%. Sir, as per the CMIE, over the 7 year period of 2017 to 2024, unemployment rates in Meghalaya have shown a generally decreasing trend, starting at a high of 8.8% in 2017-18. And reaching a low of 1.9% in 2021-22. Average unemployment rate for Meghalaya is 3.9%, while for India, is substantially higher at 7%. Also, the PLFS data for Meghalaya indicates stability with an average unemployment rate of 2.9% as compared to overall national average rate of 4.7% during the same period. Meghalaya's unemployment rate is consistently lower than the national average among both data sources. The data indicates that Meghalaya's labor market has been more resilient and possibly more dynamic in creating and sustaining employment opportunities compared to the national scenario. Measures taken by the government to tackle the unemployment problem in the state. Sir, curbing unemployment is a complex issue that typically requires a multifaceted approach, and the government is taking a concerted effort to be able to provide gainful employment to its citizens. Focus is being made to achieve inclusive and sustainable growth in different sectors of economy, such as agriculture and livestock, industry and various services through entrepreneurship development, capacity building and training, business enterprise promotion, market linkages, value chain development. The government is also taking steps for promotion of sectors which can create job opportunities like hospitality, tourism, organic farming, food processing, art and craft, music and sports. I would like to take this opportunity to inform the House that the government aims to generate an additional 5 lakh employment opportunities by 2028. 2.3 lakh of these, the opportunities are going to come from agriculture and allied activities alone, followed by trade, hotels and transportation, which are expected to create another 1.5 lakh opportunities. Construction and manufacturing respectively will account for 53,000 and 23,000 employment opportunities. Mining and electricity will together create 7,500 employment opportunities, while real estate will employ about 2,500 people. This target of the government can be achieved through strategic initiative in skill development and entrepreneur, advanced skills and innovation, international opportunities, strengthening growth drivers for self-employment. I would also like to mention about different initiative of government to provide solution to this challenging unemployment problem, which are implemented by different departments and government agencies as enumerated below. Skill development. Meghalaya is a young state with about 74% of its population under the age of 35. The youth of our state are very talented, inspired, and are ambitious to scale great heights, but face hurdles they feel they are not equipped to overcome. The state also faces a huge challenge of evolving a skill development system that can equip and also match the youth aspiration. Steps have been initiated to improve delivery systems in the state through implementation of flagship skill development. Programs under central and state funds by various departments and also the ADB assisted project supporting human capital development in Meghalaya for enhancing employability, in addition to the centrally sponsored and externally aided program on skill development, the government has taken steps to initiate state interventions to address the challenges and opportunities in youth development and youth empowerment. Several schemes and programs have been initiated for the purpose of skilling and upskilling of our youth, so as to enable them to receive gainful employment. Some of the prominent skills programs being implemented are as follows. Skill Meghalaya program has been launched for the purpose of augmenting various facets of skill development, livelihood generation and entrepreneurship being conducted by different departments under one umbrella by establishing a symbiotic relationship between all stakeholders. It is a cohesive skill formation, entrepreneurship and placement framework for state based on the current and emerging needs for the economies of the state. The program intends to cover 1.2 lakh youth in the next 5 years under the three domains of skilling, livelihood and entrepreneurship, including school-going youth, recent dropouts, unemployed adults, persons seeking certification of their skill acquired informally, and persons seeking skill upgradation. Since its inception in 2022, the scheme has shown tremendous achievement over the years. Some of the major achievements are indicated below. A, 95 local training providers have been empaneled. These training providers have also generated at least 950 jobs. B, 8,526 young individuals have been provided access to training across 223 demand-driven trades. C, 635 candidates have successfully secured placement in various job roles, earning an additional income of about rupees 1 lakh per annum. These placements not only provide stable income but also contribute to the local economy by filling critical roles in emerging industries. D, a substantial portion of the beneficiaries, 4,093 youth, have engaged in self-employment activities with an additional income of more than 75% per annum. E, to support these self-employed individuals, 4,931 youth have received startup tools essential for launching and sustaining their businesses. The government has invested about 2 crore specifically for these tools, ensuring that the beneficiaries are well equipped to succeed in their venture. Sir, till date, the government has invested rupees 7 crores in Skill Meghala program. While the annual direct income generated by the beneficiaries is expected to be approximately rupees 37 crores annually. This amount represents a significant return on the government's 7 crore investment. I am also happy to inform the House that the government has earmarked an amount of more than 53 crores as training costs and rupees 31 crores for start-up tools to train another 26,000 beneficiaries during 2024-2025. The anticipated outcome of the program: A, approximately 7,540 individuals are expected to secure formal employment with an additional income of more than 1.5 lakhs per annum. B, around 17,940 beneficiaries are projected to embark on self-employment ventures, generating an additional income of more than 1.5 lakhs per annum. C, by 2025, this initiative is expected to enable almost 25,000 youngsters secure gainful employment earning an additional income of more than 1.5 lakhs per annum. And D, this translates to a substantial economic contribution with an estimated total earning of rupees 32 crores. Financial assistance grant provided by MSSDS through its various programs under Skills Meghala 1, Skill Training in Educational Institutions for Employment, short form STEM, under STEMS, a one-time grant for CAPEX and seed money of rupees 5 lakhs is being provided to government colleges and private universities for setting up of a training center to provide free short-term vocational course. Till date, financial assistance have been provided to 12 colleges, one from each district under the STEM. BM Start. The scheme aims to enable youth to start their own training centers or be part of an existing training partner in the respective districts. Till date, a pool of 41 local trainers and instructors have been created and were trained through the sector skills councils in construction, cosmetology, and fashion design. The training and travel course have been sponsored by the government and will also provide a one-time grant in aid of rupees 5 lakh each against CAPEX for setting up a training center or introduce the job role in an existing training center they are associated with. C. A curated training program for tourism stakeholders in basic food preparation has been designed to enhance the culinary skills of individuals involved in the tourism sector, ensuring they can offer palatable and appealing meals for tourists. Fully sponsored by the government, the program provides training at an average cost of rupees 5,000 per person. Until date, 234 stakeholders have already been trained out of 335 enrolled. D. A career counseling framework that aligns closely with the state's vision to provide structured guidance and support at various stages of career development is being developed. This initiative will provide youths with the necessary tools and insights to navigate the complexities of the job market, make informed decisions, and build fulfilling careers that contribute to the socio-economic growth of Meghalaya. This initiative will empower these counselors to guide and shape the careers of at least 10,000 young people in a year. E. Forward linkage assistance to empaneled training providers. A one-time grant of rupees 10 lakhs to be provided to training providers to set up retail outlets and production hubs or service center to supplement existing efforts of ETPs in forward linkage of trainees. 12 ETPs have been provided with financial assistance of rupees 10 lakhs each under this program to support at least 500 trainees. Overseas Placement Initiative, Nursing Placement, towards empowering Meghalaya's nursing community with internationally opportunities and contributing to the state's economic growth. An overseas nursing job fair was organized in the month of August 2023. The fair facilitated direct interactions between job seekers and the international recruitment agencies, offering a platform for aspiring nurses to secure employment opportunities abroad, where 1,200 nurses participated. Currently, 121 nurses have enrolled, and the placement details are as follows. A. 12 nurses are already working in Japan of a total of 27 enrolled candidates. Another 9 nurses are scheduled to travel in August 2024, and 6 are undergoing training. B. Another cohort of nurses are undergoing training for placement in the UK and are expected to travel in September and October 2024. C. 14 nurses are already working in Singapore out of a total of 44 candidates. Enrollment for a second batch is underway. Further, the government not only provided nurses from Meghalaya with a platform to explore job opportunities abroad, but also provides a subsidy of rupees 50,000 for nurses to upgrade their technical skill set for overseas placement. Overseas Job Fair 2024. The government had organized a job fair for overseas placement on 26 July 2024 at Tura, and the same program will be organized in Shillong on 17 September 2024. The 11 employers who participated in Tura Job Fair offered almost 26,000 vacancies in 23 countries. The 10 employers who will participate in Shillong Job Fair will offer almost 21,000 vacancies from 17 countries. The government is also expecting to implement the ADB assisted project supporting human capital development in Meghala early next year. The skill component of the project will expand provision of skills training to at least 25,000 youngsters. The project will also establish a residential, the Meghala Skills and Innovation Hub in Shillong. The state has also leveraged various initiatives to the central government to uplift the skills ecosystem in the state. These initiatives have made significant strides in improving the livelihood opportunities, like ADNULM, a total of 4,552 candidates have been trained, with 3,521 achieving employment through skill training and placement. B, PM Svanidhi. This scheme has sanctioned loan to 3,436 street vendors, providing collateral free working capital starting at 10,000 rupees. C, DDUGKY. The Deen Dayal Upadhyaya Gramin Kaushalya Yojana has trained 7,343 candidates, resulting in 4,564 job placement. D, PMKVY. Under PMKVY 2, 14,139 individuals were trained from 2018 to March 2021, with all trained candidates placed in various job roles. In PMKVY 3, 473 candidates were trained in short-term programs, while 2,143 benefited from recognition of prior learning. PMKVY 4 has set a target of training 3,000 individuals, with 1,746 trained so far in diverse job roles. Entrepreneurship. The Prime program was launched in January 2020 to create and promote a robust entrepreneurial ecosystem in the state. Under the program, aspiring entrepreneurs, startups, and early-stage enterprises are nurtured to transform their innovative ideas into business. Prime aims to make entrepreneurship a preferred career choice for the youth of the state through the creation of an ecosystem that enables easy availability of credit, relevant technology, skilling, and monitoring support and market access. The flagship initiative behind Prime is the Chief Minister E-Champion Challenge and the Prime Incubation Program. It is a statewide recurring annual event through which the most promising entrepreneurs are selected to pitch business idea in front of industry experts, successful entrepreneurs, government officials, and academic leaders. Successful business ideas are supported through Prime 9-month incubation program. The assistance given includes business support grant, mentoring, capacity funding, access to further grants, access to markets, free working space, help with packaging, marketing, and branding, and networking. Till date, 150 entities have been incubated against a support of 1.15 crores. These entities generated over 2,000 livelihood opportunities in the last 3 years. At present, a cohort of 50 entrepreneurs are being trained under the 9 months. They are expected to create over 350 jobs created, of half will be a woman. Other initiatives taken up by Prime include the entrepreneurship, ecosystem development and outreach. In this initiative, Prime engages with colleges to build a culture and a mindset of entrepreneurship. A fund of up to Rs 30 lakh is granted for a period of 3 years to build and maintain an e-cell. 24 colleges have been supported so far with a fund of about 6.5 crores. Further, sir, students are guided and mentored to solve problems and ideate on community issues and problems. 4,045 candidates have been trained under the Entrepreneurship Development Program. Out of them, 460 candidates have submitted business plans and 40 have started implementing them. Till date, Prime have provided 21.21 crores to various enterprises impacted more than 6,000 lives under the following categories. Prime Kickstart Grant, Rs 1.9 crores to 35 recipients. Prime Scale Up Innovation Loan, Rs 3.5 crores to 39 recipients. NESFB Food Processing Funding Collaboration, Rs 4.9 crores. E-Champion Business Challenge Support Grant, Rs 1.9 crores. Academic Support Amount Sanction for eCell, 6.5 crores. BVT Innovation Fund, Rs 30 lakhs. Prime Rural operates across 12 blocks in the state, where in intensive tailor-made services and support is provided to identify individuals for a period of 18 months. The support provided by Prime includes infrastructure, capacity building, value addition, and market linkages. So far, 144 rural entrepreneurs have been mapped in phase one across 8 blocks. Prime has also partnered with Selco to provide solar power to rural entrepreneurs. MBMA is supporting the project by providing 50% subsidy to the entrepreneurs. So far, 69 entrepreneurs have benefited through this initiative. The Prime Facilitation Center has received approximately 1,137 walk-ins till date, out of which 59 receive advanced training on handicraft, packaging, bamboo and traditional medicine. 239 and counting have enrolled themselves in the training session on soap making, wedding dress crafting, embroidery, tour guiding, and textile weaving. CM Elevate is a state-funded flagship program aiming to make the youth partners of development by engaging and empowering them through entrepreneurship. This program is specifically designed to provide support to individual entrepreneurs, collective, village organizations, and traditional institutions to take up various businesses. Under the program, the government will provide necessary financial assistance to the beneficiaries to the tune of 35 to 75% of the project cost in the form of capital subsidy and operational subsidy as EMI co-payment. Additional hand-holding support such as training, skill development programs, capacity building programs by various government departments to successfully implement individual projects will be provided. Under the program, the individual entrepreneurs, various registered and unregistered entities of the state will have a single window portal to select and apply for any business venture spanning across various sectors based on their specific needs. At present, there are 14 schemes under CM Elevate and the total of 1,159 beneficiaries have been supported with financial assistance of Rs 36 crores. Recognizing the immense potential of the music industry in Meghala, The government had launched the Meghala Grassroots Music Project in 2022. This initiative provides a platform for local musicians to showcase their talents, preserve the state's musical heritage, and generate employment opportunities. So far, MGMP has supported more than 3,000 artists, enabling them to earn more than 10,000 per event. The Hello Meghala OTT platform has been launched with the aim of supporting Meghala's film and creative community and promote Orkhasi, Garo, and Penar languages. The platform makes it easier for local musicians, filmmakers, and content creators to showcase their work for global audiences in a commercially profitable way. Approximately rupees 10 crores per annum will be paid to the artists, adding to their income. The Meghala Ateliers program provides comprehensive support, including training, mentorship, and market access to our artisans. Through our efforts, we are enabling artisans to tap into niche markets, both domestically and internationally, thereby enhancing their income generating potential. A total of 60 artisans have benefited from this program. Our government has set a target of turning Meghala to an $10 billion economy by 2028, thereby creating 5 lakh new job opportunities. A key part of this target is investment promotion and private sector development. To realize this vision, we have launched the Meghala Industrial and Investment Promotion Policy 2024. The policy is designed to leverage Meghala's key strengths and promote investment within the state. The policy will serve as a strategic unified framework, drawing investments at regional, national, and international levels. Through this policy, we expect to generate more than 50,000 direct and indirect livelihood opportunities. The policy aims to align with the Government of India's UNNATI scheme, which is designed to strengthen the industrial ecosystem in the Northeast. I would now like to highlight our achievement in four critical sectors. These are sports, information technology, agriculture, and tourism. IT, with over 72% of its population below the age of 35, Meghala is a storehouse of talent, capable of powering a thriving high-tech sector. With that objective, one of the first projects initiated by our government soon after coming to power was the Shillong Tech Park at Umsauli. The first phase Shillong Tech Park created 1,500 direct and 4,500 indirect jobs opportunities for Meghala IT professionals in less than a year. Currently, there are five multinational tech companies operating out of Shillong Technology Park. Enthused by this success, the government is already building the second phase of the park in New Shillong Township. It is expected to generate another 3,000 direct and 9,000 indirect jobs. To spread Meghala IT's boom to the Garo Hills, our government is building a similar tech park at Tura with an investment of rupees 127 crores. Once operationalized, the Tura Tech Park will generate 3,000 direct and 9,000 indirect jobs. Agriculture and allied sectors, acknowledging the fact that 70% of the population resides in the rural areas and most of them are engaged in agriculture-related activities, our government is committed to double the income of our farmers by 2028. Some interventions taken to assist and handhold our farmers include a value chain development through farmers collective, an amount of rupees 750 crores was invested by the state government for value change development. BCM Farm is an initiative to promote area expansion and productivity enhancement of high value and long gestation crops leveraging the climatic advantage of Meghala. Area expansion and productivity enhancement of high value crops such as pepper, cinnamon, larch, cardamom, cashew, pineapple, coffee and cocoa covering over 10,000 plus hectares of land area will be taken up by the next 3 years. More than 1.5 lakh households have been benefited from the mission mode projects in the cultivation of lacadam, turmeric, khasi mandarin, ginger, mushroom and jackfruits. 343 microprocessing units, collective marketing centers and farmers market have been sanctioned at a cost of more than 100 crores. Of these, 270 have been made operational and the remaining 73 spoke will be made operational soon. PrimeHub, our innovation, a statewide rural technology cum knowledge hub, which act as one-stop solution for access to infrastructure, technology, credit, mentorship, and business partnership. These hubs are being managed and operated by progressive community-based organizations. These hubs offer services like training for utilizing machinery, support for packaging, branding, testing, and facilitate market linkages for agri-entrepreneur and farmers collection. The objective of the hubs is to cater to the spokes by promoting secondary value addition at the block level. 32 prime hubs are being established at strategic locations at the blocks at the cost of rupees 161 crores. 12 hubs have been made operational, 12 are under construction, and construction of 8 hubs will be initiated soon. Further, these hubs will create indirect employment in the form of repairing shops, guest houses, hotels, logistic services, farm supervisors, and other auxiliary services. Thus, about 3,000 employment opportunities will be generated directly or indirectly through setting up of 32 prime hubs across the state. 3.5 lakh farming households have augmented their incomes from the financial support of more than 175 crores provided under the Focus and Focus Plus. I will now share some success stories from our various agricultural initiatives. The Eastern Ribhoy Organic Farmers Producer Company Limited is set to transform the organic spicy sector in Bhoirambong block, Ribhoy, Meghala, through the establishment of the first NPOP certified organic spice processing unit. The strategic initiative is designed to position Meghala as a key player in the growing organic spice market, focusing on crops like ginger, turmeric, and chili, and aims to uplift approximately 6,000 local farmers from 116 villages. The project has a proposed budget of almost 18 crores. The Mega Food Cooperative Society Limited in Resu Belpara, North Garo Hills, is a society comprising of 700 farmers, has been supported for setting up of an oyster mushroom unit through the Prime Hub. In Resu Belpara, buys the oyster mushroom, processes and markets finished products such as mushroom powder, dehydrated mushroom, and other value-added products. A funding support of more than 10 crores has been provided. More than 1,000 farmers have benefited, and about 200 farmers are already generating income. Tourism sector. Tourism is an economic juggernaut for the state of Meghala. travel and tourism industry's potential of offering a vast array of employment opportunities, elucidates why they are crucial for industry growth. Tourism is a significant driver of economic prosperity as it contributes to job creation and spurs innovation and investment. As an outcome of critical intervention by the government in the form of investment in the last 3 years, we have created 5,640 jobs in the sector. These jobs have been created by organizing events, development of premium hotels like Vivanta and Marriott, homestays, rural tourism properties, etc. Footfalls of tourists have also increased from 12.7 lakhs in 2019 to 13.8 lakhs in 2023. The next 4 years, we hope to create another 48,500 jobs in the sector through dedicated investment in various forms of tourism, such as MICE, adventure, experimental, and wellness. Being a predominantly rural state, majority of Mikla households complement their incomes from rural livelihood schemes such as MGNRGS and NRLM. About 5 lakhs households across Mikla have earned an additional income of more than 15,000 annually during the lean season through which employment offered under MGNRGS. We have also connected almost 5 lakh women with income opportunities through 49,000 self-help groups formed under the National Rural Livelihood Mission. The PMEGP is a credit-linked subsidy scheme for generation of employment opportunities through establishment of micro-enterprises in rural as well as urban areas, thereby increasing the wage-earning capacity of artisans. The number of entrepreneurs supported under the scheme has doubled in the past 2 years from just 535 to 1,243. The financial support has also increased fivefold to Rs 102 crores in financial year 23-24. Beyond these dedicated employment generating interventions, I must point out that Government of Meghalaya itself is a major job creator in the state. According to the Census on Government Employees 2022, the total number of employees under Meghalaya government as of 31st March 2022 was 60,839. To fast track the process of recruitment, the government has set up recruitment boards in some of the important departments like Home Police, Health, Family Welfare, and Education. These are the Meghala Medical Recruitment Board for recruitment of medical professionals, Central Recruitment Board for recruitment of police personnel, and the Meghala Education Recruitment Board for recruitment of teachers in government schools and colleges. I am happy to inform the House that under the Central Recruitment Board, 996 vacant posts of various ranks of Meghala Police were filled in the year 2023, and around 3,000 vacancies will be filled up during 2024. The Meghala Medical Recruitment Board has been able to fill up 455 vacancies, including 103 specialists and about 164 posts of staff nurses, and 78 ANM will be recruited shortly. Mr. Speaker, sir, the concern of the honourable members who participated in this very important motion, they did mention about the transparency, the integrity of the concerned board or the concerned autonomous body like MPSC or DSC. Let me assure the House, sir, that government will leave no stone unturned. As far as transparency, as far as integrity is concerned, we assure the honourable members of this August House that we will make sure that the recruitment process should be transparent and also should be as per the norms laid down by different boards, different commission and different DSCs. Sir, our senior leader from Songsak just mentioned about the DSC in East Garo Hills, that only from one family, there were four candidates who passed out. I think for that, if they pass out, even 10, 15 from one family, so what's up? I don't see any problem on that. I really don't see the problem. Be it from one family or two families, as long as the recruitment process is done according to the norms, according to the regulations made from time to time, I am sure, sir, we will not mention anything about it, because it's not that the members of that DSC or the professionals who taken up the interview can just easily manipulate. It's not at all possible, sir. Sir, then again, as far as government employees concerned, I've just explained one para. And let me again assure that those vacancies which is lying vacant till today, we are again committed to make sure that the process of recruitment be completed at the shortest time, sir. So, sir, so with this clarification I made, though maybe I miss out few points, but the government has already noted down all those issues, sir. And once again, before I take my seat, I once again thank the honorable mover of this special motion and also all the members who has already shared their concern on this particular issue. With these few words, sir, I resume my seat.
Thank you. The mover of this special motion, Ba Lakman Rumbui, you may seek one clarification.
Mr. Speaker, sir, I'm very satisfied with the reply of the Honorable Deputy Chief Minister on this motion. But I just want to take note one issue. In spite of implementing so many schemes, there are some disruption in the system where the farmer, where the entrepreneur, they have encountered many difficulties. I think the government should take note that whatever difficulties encountered by the farmer in selling their product or by the entrepreneur in marketing the product, as soon as possible, the government should attend to it so that it will encourage the other parts of entrepreneurs as and when they want to venture. With this word, thank you very much. Thank you, sir.